Yeah. Thank you. There you go. Oh, yeah.
There is coming a day when our heartaches shall come. Though for a cloud in the sky, and over tears in the eyes, all is peace forevermore. All that has
mighty God, we serve thee.
Amen.
Bless the name, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Yes, remember that, Lord.
week and can't hardly get around.
Believe
and I asked him, could I get him a prayer cloth? Would he put in his billfold? He says, Mama Bell Rock. And I said, well, Mom would like to see you in church before
yeah.
you know. I like to know that you're going to heaven.
Yeah.
He said, Mom, I can stay up home. He said, I believe in God, so I can stay home and do as just good.
Oh.
And get there as soon as it's up, people, you know. And I said, well, you know, I thought that one time too.
Yeah.
Amen. Said, well, you know, we still got to get to church.
You got to get in there.
So yeah. I love him. I mean, he says, Mom, I'll go when the Lord tells me to go.
Yeah.
So I'm praying the Lord tells him to come.
Praise
amen.
God.
Amen.
And
amen.
Also, Tim Moore, his wife, told me to request prayer for him tonight that he'll, you know, he's real sick.
Just to remember me and also remember my lost loved ones in my family, especially my uncle, my sister, and my nephews. All my friends are out there living worldly ways as well, you know, that need to come to the saving knowledge and grace and truth of God's salvation through Jesus Christ.
The one that comes
here, they're out running around, and
I don't know
why they're not
here.
Oh, God, no.
Here
you go.
Here you go. Me and my family, Richard Allen, and Gary Grimes, that was killed.
Here you go, God.
You remember me, Johnny, Kevin, and Chris.
Yes, Lord. He's praying for her husband, sir. That's your achievement, sir.
Anyone else?
Remember my family tonight.
Yeah.
It's you to pray for our work stop tonight.
Yeah.
I got my sections. Lay out in the yard all night long last night. And she took to the hospital today. They picked her up, took her by
I actually have one more. Remember some friends of mine? They came down visiting from New York this past Wednesday night. They used to be saved. You know, I don't know if they're still walking in the way, the right path or what, but just keep them in your thoughts and prayers that they're walking the straight and narrow and not falling back into the ways of the world.
Yes, God.
Remember our leaders.
Yeah.
Brother John, Brad Middleton, everybody knows that his wife Diane passed away last Tuesday, and they had her funeral Friday.
Yeah.
I think it was. I went to it, and I tell you, the Lord moved in it. And I was talking to Brother Fred, and You know, it wasn't the cancer that took her out, it was pneumonia.
Oh,
and they said actually, the cancer cells, everything was doing fine.
Yeah.
But she not been eating and that, you know, it got her immune system down and she couldn't fight it. And that's what took her out.
Oh,
but you know, God received her.
Yeah.
God received her. But be praying for Brother Fred.
Yeah.
Lord, just comfort him. And bring peace to him, which I believe God's already given him peace, but he knows where his wife's at today.
Yeah.
He's in a lot better place. He even said it. You know what's so good about it? They had church.
Amen.
And man, you have seen the people standing up there raising their hands.
Yeah.
And they were singing. You could feel the anointing in the singing. And they got up there and preached. It was like being in service. And I tell you, that's the way it should be.
Yeah.
And it's hard, especially when you've got family that's gone on to be with the Lord. It's hard to rejoice. But he was going up and down the aisle praising the Lord, you know, through all of this. And the Bible says to rejoice when they go out more than when they come in. But, you know, sometimes it can be hard, especially when it's a member of family.
Yeah.
But he did that. And also be praying. You said somebody said we're leader, and but it is getting serious. Now this coronavirus, it's out there, but you know the Lord gives us common sense.
Yeah.
You know, if we're sick, running a fever, stay home. Over here, late nursing.
Yeah.
There was a woman there that has it, and there's somebody at Food City, I believe, that had it, and there's like 17 cases here in Lee County.
Oh.
But be careful when you're out and about.
Yes.
If you're sick, you know, try to stay away from it. They start July the 15th or 16th over there at Walmart. You know, we won't be allowed into Walmart without a mask.
Yes.
They're going to have service people out there, servicemen out there guarding it. And it, there's a lot to it, but I tell you, now I heard this, and I'm just going to tell you, this is part of Bible prophecy. We're already seeing it happen right before the coming of the Lord. Over there in California, they're doing away with the money, period. They're going to start using plastic, like debit cards and stuff. See, I just wanted to warn you that the Bible says when you start seeing these things, come to pass. He says to look up because your redemption
is
coming. I just want to warn you and tell you about how close we are to the coming of the Lord. It's right there at the door. You know, I'm not looking for no more signs. I'm listening for a trumpet. I'm looking for every day. Every day I'm looking for him to come out. Come back and get to church. That's what I'm looking for. All the signs is there. All I'm listening for is for a trumpet to sound. That's why I talked to my daughter about it. I said, you know, we got to get our focus on making heaven our home.
Yeah, we do.
But you know, Brother Richard, I believe we got to take many people if we can with us. I tell you, that's what's going to count.
Please.
Glory to God. When we stand before God, he's going to ask us at the judgment seat of Christ, what did we do while we was here on earth? We're going to give an account for what we did. Did we witness? Did we go visit people? Did we go visit people at the hospital, the widows? Did we do what he wants us to do as Christians?
Lord.
But we're going to give an account for it. Hallelujah. So after I got saved, my sins was under the blood, and I remember no more. But it's what I done after I got saved.
Yeah.
What did I do? And I tell you, that's what counts. And I tell you, church, I want to take many people to heaven with me. Don't you? I got family that's lost. I got neighbors that's lost. Friends that's lost. I want to see them get in. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. But be praying for our nation, because I tell you, it's getting closer and closer every day. But I'm excited.
Amen.
I tell you, this is the time to get excited.
Because
when you, Brother Tim, when you see these things coming. When you see them coming, not that you're already there, but when you start seeing them coming, it's when you should have looked up, because your redemption draws nigh. But we're right there. We see a Bible prophecy being fulfilled fast, very fast. It's being fulfilled. And I tell you, glory to God, it's an exciting time to be alive.
Yeah.
You know what? It seems like a dream when it's coronavirus and all this stuff is coming out. And there's riots and stuff and all this stuff you're seeing coming. But I believe God's going to take care of his own. Glory to God. I believe the Bible says, them that endure to the end shall be saved. Glory to God. I tell you, we've got to endure through all of this.
Yeah.
Glory to God. If there's ever a time, Brother Richard, you would think with this coronavirus that this would have drawn the church closer to God. But it seems like when they shut the church down, the people that was going.
Yeah.
But you know, this ain't the time to quit.
No.
This is the time to keep going forward. This is the time to keep looking up.
Yeah.
Glory to God, and watch and pray. Glory to God. Brother Richard says it in a lot of his messages. Watch and pray. Glory to God. And be looking up. Glory to God. Because I tell you, even though it looks bad here, but there's a better place we're going. Glory to God. We're going to a place where there's no sin, no sickness, no death. There's no hospital, no grave, glory to God, and no separation from the family. And the best part, no devil.
No devil.
Hallelujah. No one that we have to fight with in our mind every day. We're going home to be with Jesus. Glory to God. That's why I try to tell people this ain't time to go back. They have to back here to look to. Glory to God. Let the world have it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Boy, I said I could preach.
Yeah,
make a deacon want to shout. Quit them. Glory to God. I tell you. I get excited when I talk about going home. I tell you. But anyway.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. I like that. I like that. We got something that's alive. That'll get us excited. You know, I think I just leave my truck here in front of all But it all depends how I feel when I walk up to the door. Glory to God. But it's good to be alive today. I'm glad that I'm alive today. I'm glad that he gave me breath to breathe. The devil come to church. I get excited.
Because
I love to be in the house of God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I'm going to shut up. We're never even done. But I'm done, brother. I'm done.
Praise the Lord.
Glory
to God. Let me ask you a prayer real quick. Brother Sean, I'd like to offer prayer for my neighbors and friends.
Yes, Lord. Member of churches, brothers, around. Amen. Remember those that's sick and ain't here. I know Wayne and Sandy. Wayne is pretty sick, so let's be praying for him. And let's just mention these names that ain't here. Call out to the Lord. Stand in the gap. Amen.
No, Brother Sean. He was talking about that funeral he went to. You know, if we let a light shine down here, people knows that we was ready to go.
Yeah.
When you're laying up there in cold, the absent from that body is to be present with the Lord.
Yeah.
Shout them out.
Yeah.
That's something that hope you're leaving behind.
Yeah.
They look forward. We got more to go to heaven for now than ever because they made it.
Amen.
We should be killed. They beat us.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lord.
I had to tell my daddy over and over and over, sitting there in my mom's way. He sat right up there with him. He got a chair and sat up there with him. And I told him, I said, Dad, to be absent from the body is to be present with Christ.
Yeah.
I said, you brought us up in church, and now you're seeing today. An 80-year-old Matt's here.
Oh, Lord.
And his name's Pam. He's going to pray for him.
Can I say one more thing? I got to know he said that. When he said be absent from the body to be present with the Lord, there was something come to, because I thought about that today. This is what comes to my mind. When we give our life to the Lord, we dedicate our life, give our life to the Lord, we die to that old,
yeah.
That old, that we die to that. Guess what? When we die, we don't die. This old flesh dies, not with him. And it goes about, the Bible says it goes back to the dust that it comes from. But our spirit lives forever. Once you were created, put in that body, when God created, you're going to live forever from there on. And when this body, this whole body is going to go back to the dust.
Yeah.
Once you gave your life to the Lord, you live. You're alive. You're more alive then than what you was when you was out of sin. But when you die, when this old body dies out, glory to God, you're going to live forever. Glory to God in heaven. Glory to God. That old song that we used to sing, it'd be worth it after a while. Hallelujah. Glory to God. No matter what, brother. Glory to God. You've been praying for your dad. Glory to God to get saved. He's going to get saved. He just don't know it yet. But God is on his trail. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost talking about it. I said, if you've been praying for your family and you're doing your part, glory to God, worship and praise God. God's going to save your family. And you got to trust him and leave him out the altar. Glory to God. I got a brother that's lost and God's going to bring him in. And we tell him, brother, let me tell you, God is on your trail. You just don't know. You're going to get saved. And he'll laugh about it.
Yeah.
Thank you for praying for me.
Amen.
But they're coming in. If you are sincere, glory to God, God's going to bring them in. And not our way, and it's not when we want them, but one day you're going to see them at the altar. It might not be in this house and be in the church, but you can make an altar wherever you at. And God can move right then and there, in his home, in the nursing home, in the hospital, out there on the street. Glory to God, in your car. Glory to God. An altar is where you can kneel and pray and surrender. Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
Glory to God. Troublemaker. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Bless
and
you,
I'm
Lord.
Get in the Lord. Glory praise to God.
Anybody else have a prayer request?
I would like the church for praying for us.
Yes, bless.
I know my sister in heaven.
Amen. Yeah.
She
has a happy.
Amen. Yes, to thee, God. What a mighty God, a mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you to thee, God. And I pray to thee, Lord. Give me some blessing, Heavenly Jesus, Lord, that we kneel down before you today, Lord. Bringing these requests unto you, Lord. Asking upon you, like you said, to let them to be known, Lord. To call them out unto you today. Lord, and I ask you to bless amongst who in her request, Lord. Our brother Bishop and him. Lord, I know that you know the need. It comes to life today. Lord, today God help our names and her family, God. Lord, to come out for that need that you are today. Lord, at last
Lord, help her tomorrow page. Help her in each age, Lord. Trend her up, Lord, to that ride. That that'll make you in the air today. God, come by. From tip to paddy, Lord. Wind and shaggy sod. Buzz and hand. Mad and shower, Lord. God, come by. Lord, put a hunger bang into his heart, Lord. Let the thirst and the rapidness today. God, as we ask you, Lord, to move for Brother David and his mom and his family. Lord, you can see the need in help them, God. Strengthen them up today, Lord. Move for Justin, Lord. God, to help Shane and John. Lord, need your guidance. Need to feel that today. God, as we call out upon you, Lord. Knowing today, God, that you're able to fulfill these needs. Lord, as I thank you and praise you. In Jesus' his holy name. Amen. Amen. What a living Savior. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, yeah. Amen. Come on, church, and let's gather around and pray for Brother David over the table. Amen. Bless you. Yeah, he touched his right arm today. Bless Lord. Praise the Lamb of God. Touch today, Lord. Praise the Lamb of Jesus. Lord.
Yeah, I'm having a problem with my wrist and my body's arm. That's hard for me to play guitar.
Yes, come.
I don't know what is wrong with that.
God knows exactly. Yeah, he does. I bless you, Heavenly Jesus, Lord. As we lay an anointed hand upon my brother today, God, I rebuke him. Every feeling in his heart, I rebuke him today. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah. glory to God. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to the Lamb of God.
Blessed the day comes.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Y'all to pray for me. It's something like one morning woke up, just started putting some stuff down. Just hope for the best.
Amen.
Some try to catch the train. Some try to catch the boat. Thank God for the ark and Noah's day. They laughed at him, they said he was crazy. What is this rain you speak of? It's been dry for so many years. The same God that shut and sealed the door for Noah and his family on the ark is the Son. Of the vessel of the lifeboat. Thanks to Jesus, we are bought with His redeeming blood. He forgives us all our sin. He is the captain of the lifeboat. Yes, He is. Praise God for salvation.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
I wandered so aimless, my life filled with sin. Jesus came like a stranger in the night.
Ain't it good to know, church, that one day that Jesus reached down and pulled you out of the pits of sin?
Amen.
On a solid foundation. Amen. Yes. Gave you eternal life.
Yes.
And we always got something to rejoice about.
Amen.
He said, rejoice that your name is written in the land of the Lord. God saw me.
Yeah.
Lord Christ.
You sing? Yes. Yes. You got one? You got one?
That's actually long. Yeah.
I believe Tim can sing.
As the world
a lot to be thankful for.
Yes.
Really, you think about it.
What a
thing. I tell you, if you're saved, your name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Yes, God.
You've got so much to be thankful for. You know, if you've got a roof over your head, you don't have to have a lot of money. You know, that ain't what brings joy. That ain't what brings peace. It's what lives inside that brings
yes,
glory to God. You can have all the riches in the world, but you know there's always a spot inside of you, a void that can't be filled with nothing else but Jesus Christ. You can have all the money in the world and have the biggest home, 3-car garage, and every one of them filled, and all the money that you ever want. But you know there's people that does that, has all that and still don't have no joy. They're out there looking for some way to have peace and joy. There's been many a movie stars that committed suicide because it was something that was missing. It can only be filled through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's by,
amen.
Brother Tim, by having the blood of Jesus applied to your life. That's the only way. That's the only way you're going to have peace. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
But I tell you, I'm thankful. Yeah. Glory to God for what God has given me. I got a roof over my head. I got clothes on my back. I got food. I don't go hungry, as you can tell. I don't go without. Glory to God. But I'm very thankful. But most of all, what I'm thankful for, that over 9.5 years ago, Jesus came by.
Yeah.
That's how He saved me. He gave me another chance. You know, I didn't deserve heaven. I deserved hell. Glory to God, but I'm glad that God gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever, you know what, I'm one of them, whosoever, glory to God, whosoever you're called for the name shall be saved. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. I say it's an old song, but it's a good song. It's got true meaning to it. And I thank Him for what He's done. I thank Him. Hallelujah. We'll cry Jesus. We sing this all the time on the broadcast, though. Praise the Lord. Well, I got me one to sing it. My sister-in-law sing it. Now, I need to listen to her twins. She's just singing all the time. So praise the Lord. Down here on burning fire. Get it beat. Pray. Come on, get it. Follow me. Down here on the
I'm
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, thank you, God. Yes, thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. What a day. Amen. Been mighty.
I'm trying to get this way out.
Oh, sometimes this road can be rocky. I'm a child of the King. Yes, I am.
Which go in and there at
Let us pray. Our blessed Heavenly Jesus, Lord, as we come to you, thanking you, Lord, for the great opportunity. Lord, we thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. God, we ask to let this to go out to those that are lost today. Those, Lord, are thinking, oh, there's not a heaven or a hell. But Lord, I know that you told us say the straight way it is. God, and I ask you today, Lord, to touch God. Lord, to strengthen and bless. And the church said,
Amen.
Start out at the 13th again.
Enter ye in the straight, in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And
okay, hold just a minute. Ain't that pretty simple? If I wouldn't embarrass her, I would have got Ashley to tell me what the straight way and the broad way is. Huh? That's how simple it is.
Yeah, simple a child can understand it.
So simple, amen, that you could take the foolish man of this world and read him that word of God and he'd understand it.
Yeah. Amen.
How hard is it to figure out straight is the gate and narrow is the way? But listen, that what's found on the broad way. The broad way, amen, it's like jumping in a car and nothing but a straight shot, amen. Oh, you can put it to the floor. You don't have to worry. All the cares and everything ain't on you, Brother Dave. You can just have you a time. You don't have to worry about getting up on Sunday mornings and going to Sunday school. You don't have to worry about turning back Sunday night and listen to that long-winded pastor preach again. Amen. Hey, you can just stay at home and have it made. I've got news. Amen. I've heard preacher on top of preachers preaching today. You better get ready. You better get ready. If there's ever a time that you're living in now, it's the time of the coming of the Son of God. The Bible said that when he comes, he's gonna howl. You've seen these things that they like they were in the beauty contest that says Mrs. this or Mrs. that. Can I tell you, the Bible said Christ is going to have one. And upon that, Brother Dave, it's going to be written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Bless
you,
Lord. Bless
you,
Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. What are you doing back there, Tim?
I wanted to say
that
right.
He wanted to rest a while. I know what it is. Listen to what sin will get you. The Bible said, Shane, the wages of sin is death.
Amen.
How hard is that to understand? You don't even have to have a high school education to understand that.
Amen.
The wages of sin is death. That's simple, ain't it, Brother Bishop? He didn't make this the hard way. He didn't make it so difficult that you couldn't make it in to the kingdom of heaven. You know what makes it difficult? The people, amen. These people that think they it ought to be this way, that way. Listen, if the Word of God didn't say it, don't worry about it. Listen.
Amen.
Will they share life upon this?
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise you. Thank you, Jesus.
See, the broad way is an easy way. All you got to do is take care of you. But what's at the end?
Destruction.
The Bible said death. What's at the end of the straight and the narrow way?
Life everlasting.
Amen, Brother Justin. There's life everlasting. You want to know the difference? There you are. Yes, I'd rather have to pray 2 hours a day just to know that I've got heaven made than to live any way that I want and to hear the devil say, come on in. I know people getting in his brother David, and they would have plenty of this earthly stuff. Devil began to take it away. They began to get worried. They get troubled in their heart. And then you ask them a month later, what happened? There's a right and a wrong.
Amen.
There's a good way and there's an evil way.
Yep.
There's a good spirit and an evil spirit. There's nothing hard to understand. There's a heaven, there's a hell. Amen. That's all into these two that God has placed before you. He put life and death before you. Now we choose on every day that we wake up that whether which one are we going to do.
Amen. Amen.
Can I tell you the Broadway's fun? I was on it.
Amen, brother. Amen.
I might have woke up with some of the biggest headaches, amen, and not knowing where I'm going to wake up at. Oh, I thought it was fine. I didn't have no worries. I didn't have to worry about what this and or that, amen. Who's saying this or what say? It didn't bother me. But when I got on that straight path, amen, the Bible said, amen, that it's like a plumb line. Amen, if you don't know what a plumb line is, a carpenter is got it, and they'll stretch that line out. They'll make a mark there, and they'll make a mark here, and they'll stretch that line. They'll flip it, and it makes a perfect straight line. Can I tell you, the blood of Jesus Christ paid the perfect straight and way that we can make it into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
He even said we can have life and have it more abundantly. Mom and Sister Ruth probably got great, great, great grandchildren. 5 generations. Ronnie and him should have done been buried a long time ago. They wasn't people lived over the age of 40.
Now they're living 104. Why? What does the Ten Commandments teach you and I? That there is one commandment that can add to your life or it can take away from your life.
Amen.
Honor thy father and mother.
Upon the earth. And all I got to do is honor mom and dad.
Amen.
I can remember when my mom was living and I was 35, she said, son, don't think just because you're married, I can't jerk you up and take a belt and give you another whooping that you won't forget. Can I tell you, there's nothing like a mother's love, and it's the only comparison I can put is the love of Christ. He does us the same way with no age to heal. If you don't obey him, you will pay the price. You don't do what he's asking, you will suffer. For he said obedience is better than sacrifice. What is sacrifice? That means you gotta give up stuff. That's the bill. The higher standing on the end.
Amen.
It's a good way.
Praise the Lord, everybody ought to want this.
Amen, brother, amen.
You know when it's of the Lord?
Yeah.
When you're out of the way.
Amen.
Amen.
When you're out of the way. After, in the world's eyes, you're just Sister Sue. Or Sue. But in here, you've got a sister to it.
Amen.
You've got more brothers than you've ever run across. More sisters. I'm talking about people that honestly cares where you're at, what you're doing, how is your day going. Lord, I know I can only pray so much, but I know that I'm serving a God that can take that big hand and place it over the line and can watch them regardless what they're facing. When they wake up to know that God is waiting on you to open your eyes, to take that breath, to inhale life.
Amen.
Just so he can spend the day with you. Ain't no way he does that. I got news for it. Devil can tell you anything he wants. With it up to you whether you believe it.
Mm-hmm.
If we'd have listened to the devil, we'd have all been home in air conditioners.
Yep.
We'd have probably been sat in our recliner if we're like Mama Grace, we'll sleep in our recliner. It ain't a place, it's a place to sleep. Huh? Ain't you glad that you've been born again? Ain't you glad that you come to the knowledge of right and wrong? Ain't you glad that Jesus has taught you there's a heaven to Cain and a hell to Shawn? And you know what he tells us? All you gotta do is love your neighbor. Well, the love of Christ is waxing cold because we shut it up. Whoa!
Happy morning.
I'll tell you, God, and I'll tell on that devil. He tells on me all the time. Every day he goes before Christ and falsely accuses the brother.
Yep.
And the sisters also. That night, I said, Lord, it's awful hot in here. I said, my air ain't too good. I don't know if I'll preach it. I might just read it. The Lord said, that would be fine.
Listen.
Huh? Listen. The Lord will accept everything you will give him.
Yeah.
And the devil will take everything if you let him.
Yep.
Amen.
Preach.
He'll take your joy. He'll take your peace. He'll take your love. And he'll even make you think you're still a child of God. I've got news. If the blood of Christ has left your lamp, then you're at the right place to come to the altar and to get it to fill back up with the blood of the Lamb. No other way are we going to enter in but through the straight gate.
Amen.
Whoa! David got the whoo in the going. There ain't enough squalling in the house of God. Oh, me and Tim was talking the other night at our church. The janitor would sweep up not just a handful, but two handfuls of every woman that wore a Harvey card. What do you call them things? Bobby pins and hair bows. Amen. They didn't care when the Holy Ghost got them. It would shake their head. Their fancy hairdo would fall down. And God help us if that happens to Gracie. But they used to pick it up. What are they picking up now? Somebody ain't living somewhere. Somewhere we've let down somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Did the shouter go home?
No.
Did it leave when Christ left?
Nope.
Hey, I'm just as hot as you are. And believe me. My heart still level feels like it's down to that bitch, but that's all right. Amen. I'll preach till there ain't no breath in me, amen. And then I'll wait till God pump me some more in there. Huh?
Amen.
So what's happening? What's happening to the birds and the ways of God? I'll tell you what's happening. They went astray somewhere. They missed the mark. They have let down on God. Uh-oh. You were laughing, now you're crying. How many times did you used to pray? How many times you praying now? How many times you used to fast? Now you're lucky to give up an hour. How many times did you fall on your face and seek the presence of God in your life? I can remember when people got sick, they come to the altar. If they didn't get it that night, Sunday night they were at the altar standing in prayer. If they didn't get it that night, Wednesday night they were standing in front of the altar. What were they doing? They were believing that God can heal it. Now that they come up here and they don't get it, you don't see them no more.
That's right. Listen.
Yeah. I ain't got a microwave up here. I can put it in and pull it out there. There you go.
Listen. Yeah.
I can tell you what the Bible said. He said, these can come by fasting and prayer.
Amen.
My wife got smart. I didn't know they made shirts that stretched. The bigger I get, the further it stretches. But he'll only stretch to an extent. How far have you got the mercy and the love of Jesus Christ stretched out to its extent? By your easy way of living. If you got any thinking people wasn't going to talk about you, you got any better wrong thing.
Amen.
If you think that you're not going to get persecuted, then you ain't on the right road down here. Amen. Because the Bible said, they first persecuted me. They first hated me. If they hated me, they're going to hate you also. What's wrong with that old time religion? We don't need that no more. We found a fast and easy way. Get you a set of electric drums, get you some electric guitars, get you some electric basses, get you some fellers that don't want to serve Christ but love to sing. Amen, and you'll see a church shout all over the place. What are they shouting under? Can I tell you that music has a spirit that comes with it?
Yep. Amen. Preach it.
What's happened to the old time symbol? Oh, we can't play them. They'll give so-and-so a headache. She needs to sit closer to me while I pray.
Praise the Lord.
Either God will heal her or she'll get healed by listening to them samples.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Oh, they play that guitar too loud. I'll strum it another extra hard strum. I'll make the springs look like they're bouncing off the head. Can't stand to hear a tambourine. Give me a handful. Why? What does the Bible say, David, about all these instruments?
Yep.
If God is in it, don't worry about it. But try the Spirit and see if He'll be in it. But by my listen, the Word of God said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Amen.
Now I want you to listen. Listen, a joyful noise.
Amen.
Where did it say you had to be pretty slender? How a beautiful voice.
Preach it, brother. Preach it.
Uh-oh.
Joyful noise from the heart and spirit and truth.
Well, where does it say that only so-and-so can sing? And just because you can't hit a note, they won't let you sing. And God telling you to open your mouth. You know what I do? I used to be in some of them churches, the Lord looking on me while they were singing, I'd be singing. That they would be a different pair in what they were doing and what I was doing. Listen, if God is in it, brother, it'll be done right. It'll be done decent. And it'll be done in order.
Yep.
not by man's order, but God's order.
Amen.
Read that 13 again.
Enter ye in the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way.
Oh, just a minute. Read that again.
Enter ye in at the straight
gate.
Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
Oh. Broad is the way, and many will be found thereon. Narrow is the way, and straight is the gate, and few there be that find it. Little David found it.
Yep.
How do you know it? He said, let it be a light. Hey, unto my path. Let it to lead me. Let it to guide me. Let it to be a staff in my hand. Let it to lay me down in the green pasture. Can I tell you, it don't matter what you're going through. God is right there. Sometimes you just need to wake him up. You might get a scalding, but it'll be worth it to hear him say, peace, be still, and watch it lean.
Amen.
How many of you had a paragon on you so strong you went home and just could not go to sleep?
Amen.
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 Could not go to sleep. Things running all through your mind what you could have done.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Can I tell you, you've done everything you could. The first thing you done was obey. If God tells you to run around the podium, brother, you better tell Brother Richard to take a step back, because I'm about to run over it. If God tells you to walk around the church hollering, blessed be the name of Jesus Christ, you better get up and you better walk around. Listen, the Bible said that for us to stir up, I'm satisfied going and sitting on the bench, Brother Richard. I'm satisfied not feeling the Spirit of God. You're in the wrong place.
Amen.
I like that old time. Shouting, singing, hollering. What's happened to me? We've listened to man and they shut it out the door.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Listen,
living religiously and not by faith.
Read the next one. I'm going to try to hush. Yep.
Because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
How close it is. Job made it, and he was under the laws of God by the skin of his teeth.
Mm-hmm.
That's awful being. But he made it. I don't look at the skin, I look at him making it.
Mm-hmm.
We've got the blood of Jesus Christ. We are the sons and daughters of God. Our Heavenly Father sits upon a throne. Our Savior Jesus Christ sits on his right hand. And every time accuser.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
And as usual, he tucks and runs.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
How simple it is.
God bless him.
How simple it is to get a blessing from the Lord. I'd love to come to this church, and one night I couldn't get a word in crossways for people praising God. I've had it happen here several times.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Boy, God would plumb wipe me out in the spirit. Mm-hmm. I could hear everybody's voice. The spirit of God, Brother David, would be so strong. They wouldn't need no guitar playing. They wouldn't need no somebody up here singing an old song. Amen. All they wanted to do was to let the Lord know that they loved him and they praised him for everything that he brought them through.
Amen.
Because you can't get through nothing on your own. If you come through,
amen.
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 We can do nothing without it. You said it when you said, I can't even walk without him holding my hand. And you know, I don't believe he let her hands hang low when we got a hold of them. I believe he raises them up. I believe he'll raise them up, Brother Tim.
Praise the Lord.
What did he say? Raise up the hands that swing low. Why? Raise them up. Look who you're raising them to. Have you forgot the power of Jesus Christ and what he can do? Have you ever had the Holy Ghost take your mind, your body, and you have to ask somebody what happened? Because I can't know. I don't even know what happened. All I know is the Spirit come by, and that's all I can remember.
Amen. Amen.
Husbands used to get mad because their wife would come home and the hair all mixed up. They accuse them of running around. Amen.
That's true.
I sprayed you down with a woman's perfume, you probably wouldn't even go home, would you? Even though a woman had never been around him. Jealousy has slipped in to the house of God.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Where
did
that come from?
Yeah.
Big deal. If Ashley can sing better than I can, it's still the same God that I'm serving.
Amen.
And that's all that matters. That's how we ought to look at it. We're not here to please this and that. You're here to please the Lord. Look at what the Lord has done in your life so far. He put Tim, he took him down there in the basement, and he put two little boys in front of his life, and he turned his whole life around. Who could do that? Nobody but Christ.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Yes, amen.
If I was to tell Tim, that racing's wrong, you're missing out of church, he probably would have hurt his feelings. But you know, I know a God. He serves the same God I do. And he can open your eyes, and man, you don't feel that hurt. You feel like somebody give you a whooping. You feel low. Feel just like you had to leave here. If he don't come first in your life, he will not take second. He will not take third.
Amen.
If he's not the head, he's not nothing at all.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Until we surrender You know what surrendering means.
Total submission.
Come on. Now you're justin'.
Absolute submission. Giving up all.
Surrender, yeah. How many come through that door? Why couldn't that have been red flag? Why did it have to be white? Most visible color they are to see.
Yep.
Pure. It represents, oh, I don't want to get into that. I told you that I'm going to kind of hush. It's getting hot.
Praise the Lord.
But a bishop, if you were caught by the enemy, what would be the first thing you'd do?
Amen.
You don't have to hold on to that. You don't have to worry with it. You don't have to be stressed out. Amen. Put it in the hands of the mighty King and watch. The Bible said to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Do you love the Lord with all your heart? Amen.
Amen.
With all your might. Amen.
Amen.
I don't want no halfway. I don't want no, I think I am. I want him that knows exactly. We're a servant of God, Brother Tim, that would rather use us to do these works than him step in himself. When Jesus done a miracle, what did he do it for?
Glorify the Father in heaven.
No! He said, it's not I that do these things, but my Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, I don't know what I'm going to do. Today it's about me, and me's about run out. There's coming a time that doors will never close for people trying to get in.
Yeah.
Amen.
Justin, if you can feel their spirit when you step out of your vehicle, there's something going on.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
There's something happening, Brother Tim. You've stepped in the presence where God dwells.
Yes,
amen. I don't know about preachers or not.
Let me know.
Blessed.
Moses seen a fire and the bush was on fire. And he had to go look, and when he went to it, what spoke out of the fire?
The Lord.
There was a voice of the Lord. My God. God. And the Father spoke to Moses and said, Moses, take off thy shoes, for thou
holy ground. Amen.
Thou art standing on holy ground.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
When God's in it, it's holy.
That's right. Amen.
God's in you, you'll be holy.
Yeah.
You can't separate the Holy Ghost to the Father and the Son.
No.
That's right.
You can't divide them.
Nope. You have the three in one.
And the three
that.
Is one.
Yep.
If the Holy Ghost agrees, Jesus and the Mother shall be with you.
Yep.
That's right. That's
right.
Praise the Lord.
Said I was going to hush. Love you. Pray for me. Lord's will. Oh, my goodness. Ah, Lord, what a service. Ah, the Lord has been good.
Amen.
Amen.
Ah, Lord,
have
you been good. Yeah.
I thank the Lord for being here. For the meeting today.
I want to thank the Lord for being here tonight.
Bless
you. I was telling Sue that I go to bed every night and I pray.
Yeah.
So I mowed the yard the other day, got my back done myself. Like, I still pray, I'm done. And I get Bible verses on my phone in a prayer. And I said that when I was laid down. And I said, well, you know, that'd probably be enough. And something woke me up about 4 or 5 in the morning. It said you need to pray.
Uh-oh.
So I prayed and went back to sleep.
Yeah. That's my Lord. What is it good to be obedient? Every Lord. That's how she'll get her healing, is by obeying. Man, it'll come. Glory be to
God. I want to thank the Lord tonight.
Yeah, bless
you. All his blessings.
Yeah.
And the doctor told me that I need a replacement. I said, I don't want that. I don't think God wants me to put something like that in my body. And they called me and wanted me to make an appointment with the doctor so they could check it out. I said, I'm not coming. I don't need no pacemaker. I thank God I've been healed.
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Glory! My goodness! My goodness! Lord, mercy!
You know, the doctor said I had heart trouble too, but I tell you what, I do that too. I about it down. Maybe it's up or too low down. I said, God, you got this.
Yeah.
I'm not going nowhere until God gets ready for me.
That's right.
I guard my heart, doctor. Maybe we don't need you, but I don't like to meet you. The doctor's been with these boys.
Thank the Lord for being here tonight. Thank y'all. Remember, brothers and sisters in Christ, y'all may not realize what a blessing you are to me. It's good to have a place you can come to.
Yeah.
You know, it's refuge away from troubles and cares and burdens and worries of this world. Thank the Lord for the good word that we got to hear tonight.
Bless you,
Lord. So the Lord grace us with his presence, because I definitely felt the Spirit tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
And I just thank the Lord for keeping me from day to day.
Yeah.
Amen. Thank God for his protection.
Yeah. Amen.
He said, if you don't wake up by a certain time, maybe a week, maybe a month, my next appointment, maybe go out and put a pacemaker. I said, man, I can run from Suki Beach to Wallace without stopping. And I went back to Suki Ridge. There's something on my heart. He said, you're starving yourself to death. Start eating. Well, I did. I started eating. My heart rate got back up. It's 56 now. It's like, that's what I was being now. But you know, doctors don't know everything.
That's right.
A doctor, that if we only just give it to him, leave it up to all, he'll see us through. I'm 57, almost 57 now. I ain't had no more heart trouble. More type of medicine. God's got a purpose for me.
Yes, amen.
And you know, if I don't step out, what I think it's God's telling me to do, if I don't try it myself, ain't nobody else gonna try it.
There you go, where I am.
And you know, just to be honest with you, I went through cancer with a heart attack. If I disobey him now, next time something comes up on me, I might not be, I'm not gonna have another chance. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, amen. That's true, brother.
I don't want to take that chance because, like David said, time is near.
Yeah, it is.
You gotta start listening.
Amen.
It's a scary time for sinners.
Yeah, it is.
And I thank God for my family here. I love the thought. That's not like me, they tell me. Man, I'm not that type. You know, for talking about that. Sister Gracie, I understand why the child would call me Gracie. I mean, she shows, I'm not sending her, not showing anybody love. She does it. That's what I want. That way we love God, we've got to love our brothers and sisters.
Yes.
That's right.
We can put them down.
Yeah, come on, brother.
When they're down is when they need us.
Yeah.
That's when we got to give to love.
Uh-huh.
We stick together.
Yeah, bless you, Lord. Okay. Yeah. Anyway,
come Wednesday night. I got a nervous gown to leave. I've got a message.
Hey,
I got gotten at this church. This church was going to at the time. I didn't say no names. Exactly. I'm just going to tell you what's wrong with the church world in my eyes.
Yeah.
I studied this. God gave it to me. I studied it. And I got to church at that. They sung. They praised the Lord. Didn't feel nothing. They asked me to come on. So Tim was going to give the word tonight. I got up there. I opened my paperwork up and just pulled that rope down, and it just looked like a mess. It was a mess. God wanted it to come from the heart.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
But when I started delivering the message, I couldn't even hear myself for the people talking to each other. They was talking from this side to this side to each other. The pastor was in the back talking to her sister.
Oh.
I mean, then I was nice. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that
put
a stunning block in front of me.
Yeah.
I did not get over the way I should have. But you know what's wrong with churches today? Young pastors need support. They don't need to look down.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Because
I know he's just like me. We are determined.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
God is just a trial experience.
Yeah.
Amen.
And if you don't want to try them, how do you know that you're going to have a guilt?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you find out.
You've got
to try the spirits.
You got it.
And I don't know why I went there. What I say about loving you all.
Yeah.
Last week was my first time here. And I had everybody's attention.
Yeah.
That
makes
so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
It helps.
Yeah.
It helps us up here.
Yeah.
Yes, it does.
You back there talking. That's got my attention.
Yeah.
Yeah. Y'all from what God has given. And the Holy Ghost, the Spirit will lead. He won't dwell.
That's right.
What?
Yeah.
Would y'all pray for me? I'm going to make it.
Yeah.
Now this is me. I feel the Lord on this. This is David. The Lord didn't tell me to say this. But you know where you're laid off now. What if the Lord is God that you said 5 years ago God put a calling on your life? Maybe now that the time that you're in, pray about this.
Yep.
Because the Bible says he said, I will give you the desire of your heart.
Yep.
Okay, if he put that desire in your heart, and now you're seeing it now that you're laid off, now God probably got something else for you for these last days.
Yeah.
And see, I read from God. Since 94. I was in Florida, and my mom was washing dishes way up in the morning, and I was running from God, and she wrote me a letter, and she said, David, Lord's got I believe in these last days, God's got a calling on your life. And I ran from God for a long time. I ran. I was a sinner. I ran until one day when he got a hold of me. I was either going to give my life to the Lord or I was dying, going to hell.
Amen.
That's where I was going.
Yeah.
From drugs and alcohol, I wasn't probably that big around. And that's when I made the decision, said, okay, I'm going to surrender. I said, I tried to get off the drugs myself and couldn't do it. I stayed home for weeks in my nightclothes. Food would make me sick, but I quit running. On the side of a road in a little S10, I gave my heart to the Lord.
Yeah.
And glory to God, I answered that call.
Yeah.
But this might be what God has got for you. Get your attention. Glory to God, because when you're on that road driving a truck, I know I drove for about 6.5 years. And your mind's on that. But now God's got you in a place now.
Yeah.
That you can get on in that word, and God is going to, I believe God is going to
use
you these last days. You have that desire to do what God has called you to do. Now You step out and lift your church. Yes. Glory to God. Pray for you.
Yes.
Back you up in prayer. Stay with you, brother.
Yeah.
May God give them that desire to step out. This is the time that we need to pray.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Right. And God put a hedge over them and around them and protect them. Glory to God. I pray that God may use you too in a mighty way. Glory to God. And hey, you don't have nothing to look back to, but you got a future with God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I mean, God puts you here for a reason.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Glory to God. And lift up the name of Jesus. That's the name that comes out now.
Yes.
Glory to God. For people to stand up.
Yes.
That gotta pray.
Glory
to God. Put on the whole armor of God.
Amen.
I tell you, that's your protection right there.
Ooh.
And I tell you, but I'm gonna say this to you, that same thing Brother Richard told me.
Yeah.
When he was preaching over there at Brother Danny's church, you're going to go through battles.
Oh.
You're going, most of you will.
Yeah.
You're gonna go through it, but hold on. Matthew 28:20 says, lo, I go with you. All the way to the end of the world, I'll go with you. Glory to God. You got a protector. Glory to God. He kept his angels around you and keep you safe. But see, God's got a plan. God is looking for people to stand. It won't back down. Because you can't back down in this thing that we're living in. But I tell you, God will use you.
Yeah.
He qualifies you to stand for the word, and you stand. Both of you stand. There's going to be people going to come against you, like Brother Richard said. You're going to they hated. Jesus said they hated me first. They're going to hate you. You're going to be falsely accused. Jesus was falsely accused and went to a cross for something he didn't even do. Glory to God. But you're going to be falsely accused. But you hold on. Glory to God. You've got church family that's going to stand with you and pray for you.
They're
hanging around you and over you and protect you. Glory to God. I'm glad you're stepping out.
Yeah.
client said, and he talked about mortification and stuff like that, you know.
Yep.
You see your child, and he's in sin, it's Tony, I didn't know at the time, but it was Tony.
Yep.
And somebody was, I didn't know how to say it, but somebody needed to seek God because they were going to become against things that they should be in. God brought that back to my memory, not exactly like that one, but the way I said it, because he didn't know that they had what said, because it's in the Holy Ghost right there.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost will bring things back to your memory.
Yeah.
Through anything and everything.
Yeah.
I can remember
things.
He
most certainly will.
Songs that we used to sing, I couldn't remember, and I say, Lord, what's the name of that song? And all of a sudden, it's there. And I'll be singing for a scripture.
Yeah.
And can't remember. I know I'm the woman, but then all of a sudden, I'm wrapped up where he wants me to be at. We need to rely on the Holy Ghost.
Yes, we do. Yes.
You don't need the Holy Ghost. You do. You see what people say, if you come to me, I can teach you how to speak in the Holy Ghost and how to receive the prophecy of the Holy Ghost. I don't need a prophecy of the Holy Ghost because when I'm speaking in tongues, I'm speaking directly to my Father.
Yeah, amen.
He sees everything that I need. I praise God tonight. And I want to encourage every young person in here tonight,
including
your wife and all of you, and the young singers tonight.
Yes.
Jason, you have remember his name.
Yeah.
Okay. I have seen a great
upcoming. He has.
With the singing.
Yeah.
And the guitar players here. And I've been praying, Lord, anoint
him.
That's what we need.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost.
Yeah, we do.
The Spirit of God. And we've got to get that Spirit of God in us and our souls.
Yeah.
You know, we have a beautiful soul amongst
it all. Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ tonight. And sometimes when I'm praying, I can feel the Spirit of God so deep within me.
Yeah.
And I'm calling
on my sin.
Glory, hallelujah. Someday we're going to see Jesus face to face.
Yeah.
I'm just praising tonight for his goodness to me and my children tonight. They're all in sin tonight, but they need Jesus Christ. And I pray God knock on their hearts doors. Today she says, I want you to pray for me. And I want the church to pray for me. I'm not going to call no names. She said, I want y'all to pray hard for me.
Yeah, God.
I see. And all of us remember these people tonight that's lost. And this young man here tonight has families and children.
Yeah.
We need those children in church.
Yeah.
We need the wives in church.
Yeah.
I just praise God tonight for his good spirit and good power.
Anybody else?
Praise the Lord for being here. I thank you for the word. We were standing out there the other night, and Brother Tim told Richard, said, well, once the air conditioner gets working good, we need to hold church another hour longer. I believe Richard, now this is being honest, Richard did preach 5 hours straight, but he just gets the air. But I've watched him sometimes hour after hour after hour. And I'll be honest with you, it's hard to sleep with a preacher, I'm just gonna tell you. There's times they're preaching, sometimes they're speaking in tongues, sometimes they're singing, sometimes they're shouting. But you know what? I wouldn't trade 1 second, not 1/2 a second. Because he woke me up in the middle of the night preaching the hell so hot that it burned my feet. And I would ask the Lord, is there something I need to do? And that's what we're supposed to do, is help one another. I wouldn't trade it for nothing in this world. Because I know it's going to take you to that world.
Yeah.
And the Lord, once we get there, we're able to have no burdens, no troubles, or nothing. But I'm going to encourage you and Sean both.
Yeah.
Yes.
And Shane and Justin, and Justin back there,
amen.
You all are young.
Yes.
And your Lord and the things that he's doing for you, no matter what nobody says, or no matter what comes against you, just like I tell my kids downstairs, close your eyes and keep right on going.
Yeah.
Nobody's doing around you. I told Will Taylor the other day, I said, if you started singing a song that you messed up, what would you do? And she said, I wouldn't sing it.
I said, yes, you would. You turn your back to the crowd, you close your eyes, and you think of Jesus, and you keep right on singing.
Yeah.
And she said, okay, that's what we've got to do. Yeah. We've got to close our eyes to this world, because we've got to listen to that man up there that's in that world. I just thank God for everybody. I thank you for the way the Spirit leads
us. Yeah.
You know, my dad used to say, he keeps claiming to tell me about it, that when my dad would get up there, he'd get up there and sing, and he would close his eyes. Because he would not get his, he would get his focus off of people, and get his focus on God.
Yeah.
And so what he, because Glenn used to ask him, Dad, why do you close your eyes when you're up there singing? He said, because I get my focus off of people, get my focus on God. Because that's why we come here.
Yeah.
Glory to God, to get our focus and worship Him.
Yeah.
Like Brother Richard was saying in preaching, you know what this means? This also means surrendering.
Yeah.
When you lift your hands to heaven, you're surrendering everything to Him. Glory to God.
For Mary, medicine for the soul, like it says in Proverbs.
Yeah.
I can hear all that ruckus from outside.
Praise the Lord!